Are mosquito bits safe for organic vegetable gardens? This is a question that I asked myself for a long time. Welcome to Nicole's Corner. I recently had a fungus gnat infestation, and after trying a number of different solutions, I finally started using mosquito bits. When I looked online, however, I saw a lot of people that were talking about using mosquito bits in their house plants because that's where their fungus gnat infestations were primarily arising. But in my case, my fungus gnats were, you know, coming out of the soil of my vegetable plants, and that was kind of a different story than house plants because you don't eat house plants, but you do eat vegetables, so there's that. And so I just got really confused whether or not I could use this in my vegetable garden, which is my balcony garden. So if you take a look at the packaging here on the mosquito bits, you might be a little bit concerned because on the back it says things like hazards to human and domestic animals, harmful if inhaled or absorbed through the skin, avoid contact with skin, eyes, or clothing, avoid breathing dust, and, you know, it goes on and on and on, and contact the poison control if ingested and all that sort of stuff, right? So, of course, I was like, if this is organic and if this is safe, why are there all these warning labels on the package? So using these on houseplants, that's one thing, but if I'm not even supposed to touch it, how am I supposed to, like, eat the vegetables growing in the soil treated with mosquito bits? That was what I was wondering. So I did some extensive research. Like, you don't want to know how much I researched fungus gnats, mosquito bits, this bacterium, all of that. I read studies about this, and I even emailed the company. And here's what I found. The main ingredient in mosquito bits is Bacillus thuringiensis israelensis, also known as BTI. This is a naturally occurring bacterium that is lethal to mosquito larvae and fungus gnat larvae, but it is harmless to humans and animals, as well as other beneficial insects in your garden. Believe it or not, this bacterium is even found naturally on leaves and soil throughout the world. It was first discovered in Japan in 1901 and was used as a biopesticide in France starting in 1938. The EPA approved it in 1995, and it has been used as an organic pesticide ever since. According to a 2018 report by the Entomological Society of America, BT produces crystal-shaped proteins called crytoxins that kills specific insects. Once larvae consume and digest these proteins, the crytoxins pierce holes in their gut, causing their contents to leak and the insect to starve. It sounds kind of disgusting, but you know, whatever works, right? Now, the report states that humans do not have these same receptors or gut conditions, and crytoxins simply pass through our systems with no effect, like any other protein that we would eat in meat, beans, tofu, whatever. The EPA has investigated BTI three different times, in 1995, in 2001, and in 2010, and after each investigation, they determined once again that BTI is safe. So that sounds great and all, but why the warning labels? I still didn't understand why these labels were, you know, so terrifying. Well, that's when I decided I'm just gonna email the company, because the warning labels just didn't make any sense to me. How can this be safe, according to the EPA, for humans to eat, but the warning label says contact poison control if you inhale it? Anyways, the company replied pretty quickly, and this is what they said. Miss Glass, the mosquito bits are 100% safe for use with vegetables. The active ingredient only affects the true flies insect order Diptera. To all other organisms, including mammals, it is a benign protein. There are certain statements that must be included or omitted from the label regardless of how safe it is, as this is a registered pesticide. The best way to use the product for fungus gnats is to use 4 tablespoons of bits per gallon of water that you would normally use to water the plants. Put the bits in a stocking or other mesh baggie and let them soak for 30 to 60 minutes in the water. Stir or agitate the water and water the plants, covering as much of the soil surface as possible. Then simply throw away the used granules. This can be done each time you water until the problem is abated. So to sum it up, mosquito bits are safe, and the only reason the warning labels are on the package is because they have to comply with whatever legalities are required when you create a pesticide. And since I researched this, since I found all this information, I actually have no problem just like, you know, holding the mosquito bits like when I'm putting them in water, because I know they're harmless. So if you have a fungus gnat infestation, I feel for you. And I actually made a video on how I got rid of my fungus gnats. So I definitely recommend checking that out. The fungus gnats are pretty much all gone except for a few. I have some sticky traps. And if you are personally interested in getting some mosquito bits yourself, I have a link for that in the description below. But you can also find that at pretty much any hardware store. I got mine at Home Depot. So yeah, thanks for watching. Enjoy the rest of your day, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you.